Hello and welcome everyone. Today in this class, we will be talking about the poem The Felling of the Banyan Tree by Dilip Chitre. Before going into the text, first we will discuss a little about Dilip Chitre and then we will go for a line-by-line analysis of the poem and a few important points which you need to understand about it. Stay till the end of this video to know everything about this poem, which will help you in your exams. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so immediately. Thank you so much for showing support. Dilip Chitre was a teacher, painter, filmmaker, and a columnist. He lived and taught mostly in Ethiopia and the USA. He was a bilingual writer, which means he wrote in two languages, Marathi and English. He translated a lot of Marathi poems, and you can see a list of his works alongside and his short biographical note. Now, the most important element in the poems of Dilip Chitre is the element of urban sensibility. He talks about the emotions, he talks about the sentiments of the people living in the city, and through these poems, he tries to bring out the anxieties of alienation, separation, and being away from the homeland. In this poem, The Felling of the Banyan Tree, we will see how he uses this metaphor of the banyan tree and this event of cutting down a banyan tree to talk about these emotions which I have already mentioned. So now let's begin the poem. My father told the tenants to leave who lived in the houses surrounding our house on the hill. So the poet is talking about his homeland, where in his country house they used to have tenants as neighbors. Tenants means people who pay for staying at your premises or your buildings. So his father had decided to demolish or destroy these buildings for some future plan, and therefore he asked the tenants or the people who lived there to leave the place. So they went away. One by one, the structures were demolished. Demolished means broken down. So after the tenants, they left the places or the premises, then those houses were broken down. Only our own house remained, and the trees are sacred, my grandmother used to say. Felling them is a crime, but he massacred them all. So after the houses or the buildings, the poet's father, he started to cut down the trees. But his grandmother felt that trees should not be cut down, they are sacred. Now this has a religious angle as well, because in Hindu culture, in Hindu society, trees are considered to be very divine creatures, and somehow they are associated with gods, and therefore if you cut down a tree, it is a crime. From an ecological point of view, from an environmentalist point of view, this is also a crime. Okay, so but his father ignored this and he cut down the trees. Felling them is a crime, but he massacred them all. Felling means cutting down a tree, but he massacred, he destroyed the trees. And then he mentions the names of the trees that were cut down. The Shioga, the Audumber, the Neem were all cut down. Now all these plants or all these trees were big trees, but they were cut down. But the huge banyan tree stood like a problem. Now the difference between banyan tree and the other trees is that a banyan tree is a huge tree, and it does not have just branches, it has roots, you know, those aerial roots hanging from the branches and which touch the ground, penetrate the ground and make the tree stronger. So it is more difficult to cut down a banyan tree. So look at the word problem. Okay, he is calling the banyan tree a problem here. whose roots lay deeper than all our lives. So, in a way, this tree is more rooted than these human beings were, because unlike the people who were living there, this banyan tree was an ancient life. You know, it was there for hundreds of years, unlike the human beings whose lifespan was much shorter. My father ordered it to be removed. The banyan tree was three times as tall as our house. So it was not just older, but it was, you know, taller and stronger than the lives of the humans or the buildings of the humans around it. So there is a comparison made between nature, permanent nature, something which is more vital to life, and man-made buildings, man-made structures. So this comparison is made here. Now the poet describes the banyan tree. Its trunk had a circumference of 50 feet. Circumference is the total length of the tree's trunk. If you put a tape around the tree's trunk, you get the circumference. So that was like 50 feet. It was a huge tree. Its scraggly aerial roots. Scraggly means not ordered, not cut into any proper shape. So if you look at the aerial roots which hang from the trees, you will notice that they have peculiar shapes. So that shape is called scraggly here. Its scraggly aerial roots fell to the ground from 30 feet or more. So its circumference was 50 feet and the length of the roots which hung from the branches was 30 feet. That's quite tall. From 30 feet or more. So first they cut the branches. They means the people who were engaged to fell the tree, sawing them off for 7 days. Now you will have very painful description of, you know, cutting down the tree, which almost sounds like murder. You know, the tree was cut down for days and you can almost feel the pain of the tree, as if the poet himself felt that pain inside. Sawing them off for 7 days. Sawing means when you cut down a tree with a saw. For 7 days, and the heap was huge. Insects and birds began to leave the tree. Now, this banyan tree, it was not just a tree. It was home for the birds and the insects who found this a safe place to live, to nest. But when this tree was cut down, this home was taken away from them. So here you will notice that the poet is no longer talking about just a banyan tree. He is talking about the feeling of homelessness that the refugees feel when they are forced to leave their home. When the poor people are asked to just vacate their places, their premises and leave. Therefore, this element of homelessness, which he talks in context of insects and birds, is also found in the pain of the refugees who have no home to return to. So this pain is described through these lines. And then they came to its massive trunk. So then after cutting down the branches, they trimmed off the branches and then they started cutting the trunk, the main part of the plant. 50 men with axes chopped and chopped. Notice the repetition of the word. The great tree revealed its rings of 200 years. So when you cut down a trunk of a tree, you will notice that there are these rings. And people say that by looking at the number of rings that a tree's trunk has, you can guess the age of the tree. And because this banyan tree was very old, it had a lot of rings in the trunk, or which was visible after the trunk was cut. 50 men with axes chopped and chopped, the great tree revealed its rings of 200 years. We watched in terror and fascination. So there was this element of horror, as if they were witnessing the destruction of history. And they were fascinated too, because it was a sight that they never saw ever in their lives. So this was something very remarkable. And he's calling this a slaughter. Slaughter is when you kill an animal. In case of trees, we do not use this word. But this tree appeared to be as sensitive as any animal who can scream in pain. But when you cut down a tree cannot respond. A tree cannot show its pain. But still, he calls this a slaughter. As a raw mythology revealed to us its age. So he is using the word mythology here because trees, especially trees like banyan trees, they are associated, as I have already told you, with mythologies of Hinduism. And when you cut down a banyan tree, you are somehow hitting that mythology. You are somehow destroying that element of wonder which you associate with trees like banyan trees. Soon afterwards, we left Baroda for Bombay. So this country land or this village about which he's talking was in Gujarat, and they had to leave Gujarat for Bombay. And this whole incident of cutting down the trees, of demolishing these households, it all happened because of this shifting of residence that his father had undergone or decided to do. Why Bombay is important here? Because unlike his village, Bombay was a place which hardly had vegetation. And he writes here, where there are no trees except the one which grows and seeds in one's dreams. The word seeds means writhing purposelessly, to be in an emotional agitated state, that is seeding. So in Bombay, you no more have any real trees around you. You only have trees in your dreams. And what happens in your dreams? Which grows and seeds in one's dreams, its aerial roots, looking for ground to strike. So if you are dreaming about these trees, then those trees in your dreams, their roots do not have a real ground to strike. So their aerial roots, which hang from those branches in your imagination, they do not have a concrete land to settle themselves. So this feeling of being unsettled, the feeling of being alienated from your soil, that sorrow, that pain is the central theme of this poem. So this poem is not just about a single banyan tree or how it was hewn down, cut down. It is also about this pain of alienation from somebody's homeland. Now, when you look at this poem, therefore, you have to understand that the tree here becomes a symbol of this home which is taken away. And therefore, the cutting down of the banyan tree becomes a metaphor of destruction of homes, which leads to the feelings of anxiety of people who are away from their homes. So this is an emotional poem, melancholic poem, and in some of the lines you also see a lot of violent images, which is important because the feeling of alienation, especially from the point of view of a person who is uprooted from his country, that feeling of alienation is rooted almost always in violence and in loss. So I hope you have understood the central theme of the poem and the lines. If you have any question or comments on this poem, please feel free to write them down. I'll try to provide a list of questions that you might need in the exams in PDF format. You can find them in the description box. Thank you for being with us. Hope to see you soon again. Bye-bye. Thank you.